Praise the Lord, for it is good to sing praises to our God, for it is pleasant, and a song of praise is fitting. The Lord builds up Jerusalem. He gathers the outcasts of Israel. He heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds. He determines the number of the stars. He gives to all of them their names. Great is our Lord and abundant in power. His understanding is beyond measure. The Lord lifts up the humble. He casts the wicked to the ground. Sing to the Lord with thanksgiving. Make melody to our God on the lyre. He covers the heavens with clouds. He prepares rain for the earth. He makes grass grow on the hills. He gives to the beasts their food and to the young ravens that cry. His delight is not in the strength of the horse, nor his pleasure in the legs of man. But the Lord takes pleasure in those who fear him, in those who hope in his steadfast love. Welcome back to The Morning Mindset. I thought it would be good once again to just begin with the scripture, to have the first thing we hear be the recognition of who our God is. And did you hear it in those verses? My goodness, what a contrast. What a great description of who our God is compared to who we are as men and women. Did you notice there at the very end where it says, God's delight is not in the strength of the horse, nor his pleasure in the legs of a man. Now, those are images that come out of warfare. You see, in their day, a mighty warrior on his horse was a formidable thing to see. It was something you would be afraid of if you saw a fully armed soldier coming on a horse, charging towards you. That would be something both to be afraid of if it was coming towards you, but also to be proud of if it was from your nation going out to battle. And the writer is saying, as admirable as that is, and as much of a thing of delight that could be to us as human beings, God's delight is not in those things. That's not the kind of strength he takes pleasure in. He takes pleasure in those who fear him, in those who hope in his steadfast love. Now, those two verses, those two lines may seem a little contrary to you. Wait a minute, I'm supposed to fear God, but then I'm also supposed to hope in his steadfast love? Love and fear, those don't seem to go together. But let's pick it apart for a moment. Let's understand what it's talking about. You see, fearing the Lord in this context is understood in light of the contrast he's just given us. You see, we typically trust in that horse. We trust in that mighty warrior. We trust in the thing we think is going to protect us. And the author is saying we are to transfer that trust away from the human things we can see that we typically would trust in. It could be a mighty army, but it could also be a bank account. It could also be a career. It could be your own ability. We're to transfer our trust from those things to the Lord. And that is what it means to fear him. It's to put him in the rightful place of power and strength and dominance that is truly his. And the Lord takes pleasure in us doing that. It's not because he's an egotist. It's because he knows who he really is. He is the most awesome personality in the universe. He is everything that is trustworthy. And therefore, we are to hope in him and in his steadfast love. Do you see how the two go together? When we rest in him, we can trust that his love for us is steadfast because that's part of who he is. That's his character. So my friends, today, whatever you're facing, whether it's ominous things coming up in your workplace, whether it's difficult financial circumstances you're in, or some tragic health circumstance. I mean, there's all kinds of things that it could be. Transfer your trust from the situation, from the doctors, from the financial gurus, from the people you would tend to lean on, and transfer it over to the Lord. Hope in his steadfast love for you because he does care for you. Would you take a moment and think of someone you could share The Morning Mindset with and text them about this episode? And join me again tomorrow.